So welcome back students. First of all, today we will learn how to convert an algebraic expression into partial fractions. Partial fraction. So type 1 partial fraction is done when there are two linear expressions in the denominator, two binomials like this x minus, or if we write it as unknowns, x minus a, x minus b in the denominator, and x minus c, or we can write dx minus c, or there is only constant in the numerator, and in the denominator there are two binomials, product of two binomials. For example, 2x plus 5 over x minus 1 into x minus 2. Now changing it to partial fraction means what? Means changing it in such a way that there will be x minus a in the first fraction, in denominator of the first fraction, and x minus b is in the denominator of second fraction. When we take the LCM between these two denominators, it is x minus a into x minus b, and when we combine them, it is giving p at the numerator. But how to fraction them, how to change them again to its original form? This method is called the method of partial fraction. Okay, for this, first of all, we have to assume that it is equal to a upon x minus 1 plus b upon x minus 2. Now we have to find a and b only to change it into a partial fraction. Is that clear to everyone? The meaning of partial fraction means changing this fraction with two factors at the denominator into two different fractional algebraic expression. Okay. Then we write it again. Left hand side is same. And in right hand side, if we take the LCM, it is LCM of the denominator, it is x minus 1 into x minus 2. Is that clear to you? And numerator becomes what? A into x minus 2 plus b into x minus 1. So look at this. Denominator is same in both the sides, so it will be cancelled out. So it gives an identity. 2x plus 5 equals to a into x minus 2 plus b into x minus 1. We write it as identity number 1. Now, how to solve this identity to get the values of a and b? This we will discuss now. Okay. So, look at the first factor, it is x minus 2. So, we put x minus 2 equals to 0 in both sides. That is, x equals to what? 2. When x minus 2 equals to 0, 2 is transferred to right hand side. X equals to 2. So substitute it in equation number 1 in both sides of identity 1. Okay. So in place of x, 2 will be used. So 2 into 2 plus 5 equals 2. A into this we have assumed to be as 0. So A into 0 plus B into 2 minus 1. 2 to the 4 plus 5, 9. 2 minus 1 is 1. 1 into B, B. Means B equals to 9. Then we put the other factor x minus 1 equals to 0 in the same identity 1. Putting what? X minus 1 equals to 0 in identity 1. That is what? X equals to 1. So substitute x equals to 1 both sides. 2 into 1 in place of x, 1 plus 5 in place of 2x plus 5, 2 into 1 plus 5 from identity 1 equals to A into value of x is 1 when x minus 1 equals to 0. So 1 minus 2 plus B into value of x minus 1 we have substituted as 0. So it implies 2 plus 5 equals to 7. 2 into 1, 2 plus 5, 7 equals to A into 1 minus 2 is minus 1. B into 0 is 0. It implies A equals to, it is minus A. When it is transferred to left hand side, it becomes plus A, and 7 is transferred to next side. Right hand side, it becomes minus 7. So value of A is minus 7. Thus we have broken it into partial fractions. The final result is 2x plus 5 over x minus 1 into x minus 2 equals to minus 7 upon value of A is minus 7 upon x minus 1 plus B, and value of B we have calculated 9 upon x minus 2. So hope you must have understood this type of partial fraction in which there are two factors at the denominator, two linear factors at the denominator. This is type 1 partial fraction. So always remember that we can take any value of x in our identity. Identity is satisfied by infinite values of x. Identity means that equation. It is not an equation actually. It is an identity. Identity is that which is satisfied by all values of x. So we can take any value of x. And we have taken x minus 2 equals to 0. Why? So that this becomes 0. A into 0. So there will be only B in the identity. So we can directly find the value of B as 9. And when we have substituted x minus 1 equals to 0, that is x equals to 1 in the same identity. Now this time B will be cancelled out by multiplying it with 0. B into 0 is 0. And then only A remains in the identity. So it will directly give the value of A. So to directly find the values of A and B, we can use this method. Similarly, we can solve, we can break the algebraic expression with three linear factors at the denominator also with the same method, x minus 1, x minus 2 into x minus 3. If there are three linear factors at the denominator, this is also the same type. And in the denominator, in the numerator, always remember, if at the denominator there are three factors of x, means product will be x cube. Product will give x cube. So numerator must always be has the degree less than 3. That is 2 or 1 or constant 2. Means if it is in the form 2x square plus 5x plus 1. So we can solve this also. So try to solve this yourself. This is for the practice. So I am giving you time. So okay, now let's discuss it. So remember, these are the partial fractions with all factors linear, means all linear factors at the denominator. Understood? All linear factors at the denominator, whether they are 2 or they are 3. So in this question, when there are 3 factors at the denominator, all of them are linear. So we separate it with the same method into the partial fraction. A upon x minus 1 plus b upon x minus 2 plus c upon x minus 3. Then take the LCM of the denominator in right hand side. Left hand side will remain the same. Equals to x minus 1 into x minus 2 into x minus 3. So a into 2 factors, x minus 2, x minus 3, plus b into x minus 1 cancelled out. Sorry, x minus 2 cancelled out. X minus 1 into x minus 3 plus c into x minus 3 will be cancelled out. X minus 1 into x minus 2. Now denominators will also be cancelled out. So the remainder is 2x square plus 5x plus 1 equals to a into x minus 2 into x minus 3 plus b into x minus 1 into x minus 3 plus c into x minus 1 into x minus 2. This is identity number 1. So first of all, we put the first factor x minus 1 equals to 0, that is x equals to 1 in identity 1, to get 2 into x square means 1 square plus 5 into 1 plus 1 equals to, when we take x minus 1 equals to 0, that is x equals to 1, it will be a into, in place of x we write 1, 1 minus 2 into 1 minus 3. It implies that 2 1s are 2 plus 5, 7 plus 1, 8 in left hand side equals to a into 1 minus 2 minus 1, 1 minus 3 minus 2, minus 1 into minus 2, 2. So 2a equals to 8, that is a equals to 4. Then we put the other factor x minus 2 equals to 0. That is x equals to 2 both sides. So it becomes 2 into 2 square plus 5 into 2 plus 1 equals to, and if you have doubt in your mind, where are the other factors which are after b? Aray bhai, when we have put x minus 1 equals to 0, so it is b into 0 will be 0. And the third also has x minus 1 as one of the factor, so it will be 0. So it is 0 plus 0 plus a. So only a into minus 1 into minus 2. Is that clear to you? So a equals to 4. Now when we have kept, when we have put x equals to 2 in both sides, 2 into 2 square plus 5 into 2 plus 1 in this, x minus 2 is 0, so a into 0 will be there, plus b into, in place of x we write 2, minus 1 into, in place of x we write 2, 2 minus 3, and third factor also has x minus 2, so it will also be 0. Third term also has x minus 2 as one of the factor, so c into 0 will be 0 again. So there will be only b in the right hand side, and left hand side 2 4s are 8 plus 10, 18, plus 1, 19, equals to a 0, b into 1 into minus 1 is minus b. It implies b equals to minus 19. Then third we put what? The third factor, x minus 3. That is x equals to 3 both sides. So it gives 2 into b square plus 5 into 3 plus 1 equals to a into x minus 3 is 0 plus b into x minus 3 is 0 plus c into value of x is 3. So 3 minus 1 into 3 minus 2. It implies 9 to the 18 plus 15, 33 plus 1, 34 equals to a into 0, 0, b into 0, 0, 0 plus 0, 0, and finally c into 2, 3 minus 1, 2, 3 minus 2, 1, 2c. That is c equals to 17. So we have not to calculate only the values of a, b, and c, but we have to change it to partial fraction, to which is 2x square plus 5x plus 1 over x minus 1 into x minus 2 into x minus 3, which we have assumed as a upon x minus 1, value of a is 4. So 4 upon x minus 1 plus b, value of b is minus 19. So minus 19 upon x minus 2 plus c is 17 upon x minus 3. So the final answer is 4 upon x minus 1 minus 19 upon x minus 2 plus 17 upon x minus 3. So hope you all must have understood this. So after discussing this, let's now discuss type 2. Type 2, in which there are linear factors at the denominator, like the previous one, and linear factors at the numerator also. But both are producing x square, means the degree of numerator equals to degree of denominator. Okay. Degree of numerator equals to degree of denominators, and with all linear factors. So first of all, what we will do? First of all, we will multiply the two factors of the numerator. It will give x square minus 4 plus 5, 9x minus 4 into minus 5, 20 plus 20 over denominator. X square minus 2 plus 3x minus 5x plus 6. Then we divide, as usual, numerator x square minus 9x plus 20 with the denominator x square minus 5x plus 6. Clearly, it will give only 1 as the quotient, as both the degrees are same. So on subtracting, minus will be cancelled out, plus will be there, minus. So x square minus x square cancelled out, minus 9x plus 5x, minus 4x, 20 minus 6, 14. Now we use the method that numerator upon denominator equals to quotient plus remainder upon denominator, that is divisor. Denominator is the divisor. So how to write this fraction now? It is now 1. Quotient is 1 plus remainder. Remainder is minus 4x plus 14 over D for divisor. Divisor is x square minus 5x plus 6, and we know that it is 1 plus, we write it 14 minus 4x positive first, and denominator has the factors x minus 2 into x minus 3. So now we will find the partial fraction of only this using the method which we have discussed in type 1. So 14 minus 4x upon x minus 2 into x minus 3 equals to taken as a upon x minus 2 plus b upon x minus 3. When we take LCM, the denominators will be cancelled out from both sides. Now I am not writing that step. And when we put what? X minus 3 equals to 0, that is x equals to 3 both sides, it is producing 14 minus 4 into 3 equals to a into 0, x minus 3 is 0, plus b into 3 minus 2, x equals to 3. So 14 minus 2 equals to b into 1, b only, that is we have calculated b equals to 2, is that clear to you? And then put what? The second factor x minus 2 equals to 0, that is x equals to 2. So it is giving 14 minus 4 into 2 equals to a into 2 minus 3 plus b into 2 minus 2, which is 0. So 14 minus 8, 6 equals to a into minus 1 plus 0, that is a equals to minus 6. So the final answer of the given question, we have to find the partial fraction of this term. So write it, write the original term, x minus 4 into x minus 5 over x minus 2 into x minus 3 equals to, use this one, 1 quotient plus, and this 14 minus 4x upon x minus 2 into x minus 3, we have made its partial fraction as a upon x minus 2, where a is minus 6. So minus 6 upon x minus 2, and b is 2. So plus 2 upon x minus 3. So it is 1 minus 6 upon x minus 2 plus 2 upon x minus 3. So this is the partial fraction of x minus 4 into x minus 5 over x minus 2 into x minus 3. Similarly, we can find the partial fraction in that case also when, this is also the same case, when the degree of numerator is greater than the degree of denominator. We have to divide in this case also with linear factors only. This time we are discussing only the linear factor, degree of denominator with linear factors only. For example, if in the numerator it is given that x cube, it is not necessary to write it them in factor form. If it is directly written x cube plus 4x square plus x minus 8 over x minus 2, x minus 5. Now this time degree of numerator is 3 and degree of denominator is 2 only. So the same procedure will be followed out. That is, first of all, we will find the product of the denominator, which is x minus 2 into x minus 5, x square minus 7x plus 5, 2 is 10, and divide the numerator x cube plus 4x square plus x minus 8 with that. So into x, it is x cube minus 7x square plus 10x. When we multiply this x with this term, it is giving x cube minus 7x square plus 10x. Then subtract it. For division, we follow this process. So this is giving x cube cancelled out. 4x square plus 7x square, 11x square, x minus 10x, 9x. And finally, minus 8. The next is 11. So when we multiply it by 11, 11x square minus 11 sevens are 77x plus 11 tens are 110. So now we subtract it, minus plus minus 11x square cancelled out, minus 9x minus plus 77x is 68x minus 118. So this is the remainder now. So similar procedure will be followed. That is quotient. Quotient is this time x plus 11 plus remainder. Remainder is 68x minus 118 over denominator. Denominator is x minus 2 into x minus 5. Now make the partial fraction of this second term. 68x minus 118 over x minus 2 into x minus 5 with the same procedure as we have discussed in type 1 partial fraction. A upon x minus 2 plus b upon x minus 5, that is 68x minus 118 equals to a into x minus 5 plus b into x minus 2. When we put x minus 5 equals to 0, it is giving x equals to 5. So 68 5s are 340 minus 118 equals to a into 0 plus b into 5 minus 2. That is 3b equals to 340 minus 118, 222. Okay, so b equals to 222 by 3, that is 74. So the value of b is 74. Then we put x minus 2 equals to 0, that is x equals to 2 in both sides of this identity. So it gives 68 2s are 136 minus 118 equals to a into x minus 5, 2 minus 5. So it is 18 equals to minus 3a. So a equals to minus 6. So the final answer is for x cubed plus 4x square plus x minus 8 over the two factors, x minus 2 into x minus 5 equals to this x plus 11 plus a means minus 6 upon x minus 2 plus b means 74 upon x minus 5. So hope you all must have understood this. So this is the final answer. So in this we can write type 2 as degree of numerator is either greater than or equals to the degree of denominator with all linear factors. We will follow the procedure that first of all we have to divide numerator by denominator, then we use this method. Numerator upon denominator equals to Q. Q means quotient plus remainder upon divisor. Is that clear to everyone? So solve this question also with the same method.